What is the opposite of worry? Heaven letter number 5522. January 6, 2016. Moonlight and sunlight are both light. Moonlight is more subtle, softer. Moonlight is the reflection of the sun. Life provides you with light both day and night, to say nothing of the light within you. You are provided for. You are taken care of. You don't doubt the sun and the moon, and, yet, you may still feel like an orphan adrift in the world, as if life is too rickety for you. You may have a tendency to see the downside. You may have a tendency to cry wolf before the wolf arrives. You may feel you live with the wolf howling at you by day and by night. You may have a tendency to feel forlorn or driven to distraction, sometimes day in and day out. You may find it hard to sleep, and you may find it hard to live life in the world. You may have the idea that you are to rule the roost, and you hold on so tight to imagine control. You do this for self-preservation. Of course, the world you live in is filled with opposites. If you have to choose an opposite for the word control, the opposite could then be called trust. Yet how do you feel trust when you are so unsure of your place in the sun? Do you need proof before you can trust? You have proof that the sun rises and the moon comes out at night. However, your wayward heart may say, "But what about next time? I don't feel that secure." Sometimes, you may feel that the sun and the moon simply do not offer enough restitution to you, as if they are not good enough. You may ask, "What good are the sun and the moon when I am in a situation where I cannot see them?" Dear ones, you are so inured to the downside even as you have been rescued time and time again. You may feel that the best you can do is to weather life. Yes, you have gotten through this, and you have gotten through that, and yet you worry that the boogeyman death is reaching out to appropriate your life on earth. You've heard about heaven, and you would desire it for all you are worth, yet, at the same time, your fear of illusory death and the fateful journey to it hover over you more than you would like. Can you have more confidence in me? Can you have more confidence in yourself? New horizons exist as well as your plaint of so long to earth this time. You may perhaps mourn ahead of time the very life that, on one hand, you may find indefensible and, yet, you can't bear to let go of. Beloveds, you have had enough suffering, and yet you keep on counting on more. You long for the past to tide you over the hills of today. You may not even value the future any longer, for you hear thunder and see lightning flashes before you in the rockiness you live in. Have you forgotten that every day presents you with a new horizon? Will you remind yourself? Are you duty-bound to think of downfalls so much? The concept of losing seems to be uppermost in your mind. Sometimes you feel rather victorious in all the heartache you have been through. You ponder what heartache awaits you now. Forgo the heartache of the non-existent past, and forgo the heartache of the non-existent future. Forgo heartache. Life is really not too much for you, yet you keep fighting life and say it is too much for you. You object to it. The truth is that you live in a palace, and you spend much time in rearranging the furniture. You worry ahead of time. You spend your time on dismay and worry. Where do opposites exist? They exist within your thoughts. Abandon opposites. Make up your mind. Reawaken your joy in life. Treasures await you. Receive them today. Welcome them. Know they are for you. Channeled by Gloria Wendroff. HeavenLetters.org